Good afternoon, everybody. Happy New Year. Just wanted to have a conversation with everybody today. Going to give it about 30 seconds or so and let some people jump on here and, just share with you what's on my heart and some direction for 2019 and some of the things that I'm thinking about, that I'm feeling, that I'm going through. I'm going to share with all of you and maybe get some nuggets from that, or, you know, if I could touch or help one person with this Facebook Live today, then my job's accomplished. But, you know, I have a good friend of mine that says whenever we talk to people or we're training or we're speaking or whatever we're doing, you know, we always have this intention that what we're trying to speak to someone or share with someone is for their benefit. And the truth is, when we speak to someone like this Facebook Live, or we're teaching or coaching or mentoring or just sharing with a friend, you know, in a group, let's say it's a group, you know, when you're sharing with someone, although your message, you're trying to do the best you can to hope that it impacts somebody, the person that gets the most out of whatever you have to say is yourself. You know, my good friend says it's like this, one finger out. You know, if you point to somebody, I don't mean to be rude, but one finger out, there's three fingers pointing back at you. So if you hold your finger kind of like a gun, right, you're pointing. You got one finger going out, but you got three fingers coming back. So I'm just going to jump on here and share with you some of the things that are on my mind for 2019 and things like that and see what's happened. I see a lot of my good friends that I haven't seen there in a while. Hello, everybody. Boy, there's one guy I haven't seen there in a very long time. John, Happy New Year, John. I haven't seen you in ages. Good to see you, buddy. Hope you had a good New Year last night. You know, it's kind of ironic how things happen. And I'll tell you that I'm a big believer. I'm a man of faith, you know, and I'm not going to turn this into a any type of religious or service or anything like that. But I'm a man of faith. I believe in a higher power, and everything happens for a reason, and everybody meets for a reason. I truly believe that. And I was going to do this Facebook Live a little while ago, and for some reason I started doing stuff. And anyway, I'm here now. And ironically, the things that I wanted to talk about today that were on my heart, I'm looking over here to my left because there's a TV over here. I don't watch TV very much, but in my office, I always have it on either for some background noise or, you know, during the week, you know, when the market's open, I might have the stock channel and stuff like that, just for a little bit of background stuff. But I don't really watch television. But right now on my TV is the movie The Bucket List. And it's kind of funny because my talk's going to be about that topic, so to speak, about doing the things that you want to do in life before we unfortunately don't have a chance to do it. And what's funny is at the moment that I switched to this channel, it was on if any of you saw the movie, I don't know if you have, but if you've seen the movie Bucket List, or you go and see it at some point, you see it, you know, with Morgan Freeman and Jack Nicholson, they're in Africa, South Africa, and or in Africa, I don't know what part, I shouldn't say South, but they're in Africa and they're on a safari. And it just so happens that one of the things that I wanted to do in 2018 was go see my good friends in South Africa and visit them and go on a real safari, you know, a real one where you're out there in a vehicle and there's wild animals that would eat you alive around your vehicle. That's what I wanted to do. And it's ironic that it's there. So my message today, and I don't have a message. Again, this conversation with all of you, and thank you guys for tuning in. Hey, Rick, I think you're overseas, buddy. It's good to see you. Happy New Year to you and your family. There's a good friend back from my home area in New Jersey, Gabe Stano. Gabe, it's great to see you. And I'm sorry that I'm not saying hello to all of you as you come on, but hello to everyone and Happy New Year to everyone joining us and here with us and taking time out of your new year to listen to me with my funky glasses here. I just thought I'd change it up a little bit. I've never done a Facebook Live with some kind of affectation. Is that the right word? You know, I'm not real smart, but you know, they got cool little blue rails here and they're pretty cool. So I thought I'd throw them on. I don't know if I can take them off or not electronically here, but anyway, so going back, you know, today it's New Year's, okay? Now, for some of my friends, I've missed you. Some of my friends over in Australia, in the other parts of the world, you're on here, or you're gonna see this, and it's already January 2nd. I've missed you because it's late here. It's in the afternoon here. But anyway, it's the beginning of 2019. And my feelings today, or my actions have been, and the message starts with, you can do one of two things with your life, with your year, and it's simply this. You can treat today as day one, right? You can treat this as day one. Doesn't matter how old you are. It doesn't matter where you are in your life. And I'm not talking business. It can be professional, of course. It can be personal relationship. It can be spiritual. It can be anything you want. Health. All right, but today can be day one. Or you can say one day. Okay? So it's one day. One day I'll do this. One day I'll do that. One day I'll get healthier. One day I'll lose weight. One day I'll go on vacation. One day I'll make more money or get my dream house. Whatever the deal is. One day I'll get a relationship with the man upstairs. Whatever it is. So you can either say one day. That's going to be my title for today's message. One day or day one. All right. So it's either one day I'm going to do it, or you can make a decision and this is day one. For me personally, this is day one. Okay. Actually, oops. I lost you guys. Hold on. I hope you're still there. I tried to take somebody off my screen and I lost yous. Okay. Hopefully I'm back. Somebody give me a thumbs up or something. Okay. If I'm here, I'm not a professional Facebook live person. So a text came in or something. I swiped it out and I lost y'all. But anyway, hopefully I'm still here. So, you know, I made the decision to make 2019 day one. And I'll be honest with you, I'm on like day three or four, because for me, because of what's going on in my life, Christmas Eve was my New Year's Eve, theoretically kind of speaking, and Christmas Day was my New Year's Day. And then I started my year. I got a little head start. And you know, that's all it takes. You know, I said decision. I made a decision. You know, it only takes a split second to make a decision to do whatever it is you want to do. It doesn't matter. It literally, the thought come in, boom, make the decision. I'm going to change it, or I'm going to do something, or I'm going to make it happen, or I'm going to spend more time with my family, whatever it is. But it only takes a split second to make the decision. So wherever you are in life, it doesn't matter if you want to change a circumstance or you want to elevate something in your life or change something or add something or whatever, do it. Make the decision. Now, it takes two things. You know, a lot of people say, well, I'm going to make the decision. You know, a lot of people have, you know, I didn't hear it this much. How about you guys? You guys can chime in or comment if you like, but I haven't heard anybody really talk about New Year's resolutions this year like I normally do. You know, normally weeks before you're hearing about resolutions, I'm going to lose weight and I'm going to start on the first and all. I haven't really heard that this year, but you know, many people make decisions to do a lot of things. And since losing weight or getting healthy is a popular one for a new year, let's just use that for an example. Okay. And I don't have anything scripted out, so I might jump around a little. So forgive me for that. I'm just going from what's in here right now. But you know, you might make a decision that, hey, on January 1st, I'm going to start exercising, or I'm going to eat right. I'm going to go through the holidays, cheat, and eat all this stuff that isn't so healthy for us. And then I'm going to do good. That's a decision. Or I'm going to go on vacation this year. Or I'm going to look for a new job. Or I'm going to get a side hustle. Whatever. Making the decision is only step one. And it doesn't take weeks, days, years, hours. Takes a split second to make a decision to do something. Here is what the most important thing is. You can't do it without the decision. So first is the decision. The second thing is you got to take action. Let's go back to the health, okay? My good friend, same friend, he's my best friend in the world, has a lot of wisdom and a lot of knowledge. It's real simple. You can make all the decisions in the world. You can make all the plans in the world. You can get all the knowledge. You can go online and research, working out, eating right, nutrition, all this stuff. okay? Or if it's a relationship, I'm going to do this, that, and the other. If it's a business, I'm going to do this, that, and the other. If it's spiritual, I'm going to read the Bible. I'm going to go to church. Whatever it is, okay? You can make the decision. You can get all the knowledge. You can study till your heart's content. But the key thing in anything is to take the action to do it. The analogy I'm going to give you, which is given to me all the time by my best buddy, is you got to go to the gym, so to speak, whatever you're doing, and you got to lift the weights. See, it doesn't matter how much we know. It doesn't matter how many decisions we make. But if you don't take the knowledge, if you don't take the decision and go to the gym, theoretically, and lift the weights, there are no results. So if you want to change your marriage, okay, you want to change parenting, different friend, you want to be a friend, you want to be healthier, you want to eat better, you want to get in better shape, you want to make more money, you want to, whatever it is you want to do, the list goes on and on. But the way you do it is you got to lift the weights, okay? Learn the how-to. I tell you what, the how-to will get better when you lift the weights. A lot of people say, well, I don't want to get started till I learn. I don't want to go do that. Just go do something. Take action. You know, you can have all the knowledge in the world. You can study from the best nutritionist. You can have a workout plan. You can have the best exercise equipment in the world. And for those of you just joining me, this isn't a fitness talk. I'm just using the gym as an analogy. But you can have the best equipment in the world. You can have the best everything in the world. But unless you, in this case, me, goes over to, like, I have a fitness center 24 hours on my property here. It's part of the clubhouse, right? If I don't go over to the clubhouse and I don't lift the weights, I'm not going to get any results, okay? Arnold Schwarzenegger, a lot of you guys know Arnold, right? You can't go look like Arnold by someone else hanging out with you at the gym and watching them lift the weights. I don't know if this is tracking with you guys. I don't know if you're getting any of this or if I'm making any sense. I'm making sense to me, but I might not be making sense to you. But if I'm making sense, somebody give me like a thumbs up or a hi or whatever. Hello, Sandy. Good to see you. Hey, Julio down in Mexico. Good to see you. So, you know, a lot of times in life, I'm going to bring it back home here to my message because I can get sidetracked real easy for those of you that know me and turn this into a 4-hour live. I'm not going to do that. So to bring it back to center here, okay, a lot of us, myself included at times in my life, a lot of us take the position is we're always like watching and we make excuses for ourselves, okay? I'm not ready. I'm not smart enough. I'm not good enough. I don't know enough. I'm not skinny enough. I'm not tall enough, you know, that kind of stuff, right? And we watch other people do it. And what happens a lot, and this is just coming to me as I think about it, you know, as we look at them and say, man, I want to be where they are. I want to do what they're doing, or I want to have their life, or I want to have their body, or whatever the case may be, right? But you know what you're doing? What I've done is you watch other people do it. And you're watching them lift the weight, so to speak. They're taking action, and you're watching. You got to get off the sidelines. You've heard that kind of talk. You got to get in the game. Get in the game. It doesn't matter. You don't need to be a Hall of Famer in your own life. You just got to get up and get engaged. And that's it. And the speed that you go doesn't matter. One thing I always tell people, especially either people I'm mentoring or if I have a client or anybody, even a good friend, doesn't matter. Anybody that talks to me. Because if you know me, I'll talk to anybody that wants to talk to me. Just reach out and we'll get on the phone and we'll chat about whatever. It doesn't matter. But, you know, what I used to do, and this took, you know, I've been on this earth almost 50 years. I'm 49 and a half years old, and I'm still learning. I always learn, but I do got a lot of wisdom in this brain and body. You know, I believe I probably lived the life of a 150-year-old, and that's no lie. We can talk about that privately if you guys want to talk to me, but, you know, seriously, you know, get a little choked up here, you know, I lost my little train of thought. Hold on here a second. I was on something here. You know, oh, I know. People have a tendency to measure where they're at or where they should be, you know, or how fast they should get there, or how much money they should have, or how many toys they should have, and whatever. We have a tendency to measure that by what people that we see around us, okay? And let me tell you, things aren't, I would say most of the time, the way they're perceived, the way you see them. Okay, there's always stories behind things. Maybe why people are a certain way or have a certain thing, or whether they're doing good or doing bad. You know, there's a lot of people that are doing bad or not doing so well. They're struggling, but there's circumstances for that. Or maybe someone's, you know, unfortunately overweight or really heavy, maybe really overweight. Maybe it's not their fault. There's circumstances. Some, you know, we have choices, but sometimes even when we make the good choices, we don't have control of the outcome. The only thing we can do is make the choices and do the right things. The rest of it, we got to just surrender and give it up, right? So, you know, when you're running your race, we'll use that. When you're running your race, and again, whatever it is, health, personal, professional, business, spiritual, doesn't matter. Whatever you're doing, whatever you're focused in and lasered in on, run your race. It's not really a race. It doesn't matter how fast you get to the finish line. What matters is you get to the finish line. And the finish line in whatever the category, and we'll just use that word success, we'll use finish line success. The definition of success is whatever you define it as. It's not what a book tells you or Forbes magazine or your boss or your neighbor or doesn't matter. Success is whatever you want it to be in this particular subject that you're on, whether it be weight, health, business, personal, family, marriage, whatever, right? Whatever you want finish line success to be is up to you to define that. Then once you have it, three things: burning desire to go get it, willingness to work for it. Doesn't have to kill yourself 24/7, but you got to do something, okay? So you got burning desire to go get it, willingness to do some work to get it, to obtain the success that you defined, and most of the time, a little coachable and teachability from someone that knows how to help you get there. And if you don't know someone like that, find someone. If you can't find someone, ask me. I'll help you. Because one thing I'll do is I'll talk strongly about a topic or a subject or a business or personal if I know for fact. If I don't know, I'll tell you. I don't try to talk about something I don't know. But if I know, I will talk strongly. That's another topic. So, you know, run your race. I have a saying to people, you know, run your race, do it as fast as you can, but within your lifestyle, within the responsibilities of your life. And don't look sideways. Get those things, if I don't know if they have them for people, but those of you that are my horse friends, you know, they put those blinders on for the horses, you know, so they just run straight. Run your race. Don't worry about who's in front of you, who's behind you, because doesn't matter. Most of the time, it's not helping you. They're not going to help you. If it's money, they're not going to pay your bills. Whatever it is, when it comes down to crunch time, very few people are going to do the things that you need them to do. Worry about your race. Because I will tell you this from personal experience and helping people over and over and over. Man, when you get to that destination of whatever the goal is in the particular thing that you're trying to accomplish, man, once you're there, it doesn't matter. It don't matter if you did it in 6 months. It doesn't matter if you did it in 6 weeks. It don't matter if you did it in 6 years or 16 years. When you arrive at the point that you're trying to get to, it doesn't matter. You're there. You're like, I made it. And it's irrelevant how long it took. And it's irrelevant the stuff you've been through to get there. So make the decision. Take some action. If you need help with a plan, get someone to help you with a plan. And that's it. Now, some of you might sit there and say, you know, that know me, don't know me, or just hearing this for the first time, because you could see this on YouTube and LinkedIn and you might Twitter. Who knows where you're going to see this if you choose to watch it. So, you know, you might say, well, it's easy for that guy to say, or, you know, he doesn't know what I've been through, and he doesn't know what my challenges are, you know. And let me tell you, looks can be deceiving. You've heard that before, right? And perception is a whole other thing. You know, I've been through challenges. I understand. I'm speaking from a position of authority because I've been there. I've walked in many of your shoes. Not everything. I haven't experienced everything in life, nowhere close, but there's been my share. And just recently, just the last few days, but I made a decision not to let it rip me apart and not destroy me and take me down and make the decision to come on here and talk to you guys about what's on my heart. But I will tell you that, you know, whatever your life circumstances are, we all have them. All of us have something at either now or had it in the past, or some of us, unfortunately, have it coming in the future. But we all have challenges. I really don't know anybody that life has just been... you know, just a constant since birth, you know, just steady, you know, I don't know anybody like that. And I know a lot of people, you know, I know everyday people. I know sports players, movie star. I know a lot of people. And on that boob, I call it the boob tube, excuse me if that's not allowed to be said anymore, but the television, you know, it's not a tube anymore, but the boob tube from when I was a kid, you know, even life might look pretty for those people out there, but you know, sometimes later on what do they call it, like the E! Hollywood stories and that kind of stuff, their life isn't so pretty behind closed doors, right? So perception is a son of a gun. So don't worry about what's going on in other people's lives. The only thing that matters is what you're doing with your life and the decisions that you make. Now, we all heard of this, I'm sure, I don't care how old you are, even if you're about 19, you probably heard this, but if you haven't, I'm going to spring it on you. When I was young, well, really through my whole life, but in sales, when I was young, a young man in sales, you know, I heard something all the time, the harder you work, the luckier you get, right? The harder you work, the luckier you get. Or a lot of people say, man, that person's lucky. That person, man, look at their life. Look at everything. They got it all, okay? Chances are they worked hard, and that's why they look like they're lucky. My opinion. Remember, everything here is my opinion, guys. This is an opinion of Dave Angelo. But, okay, I don't like the word but. However, what I believe is, or let me reverse this. I'll tell you what I've experienced. The luckier I get, or excuse me. Oh, my chain got caught up. I realize that I am luckier and more blessed with the more people that I help and the more I care about others. So the more that I focus on someone else, the more that I focus on someone else's problems, the more that I focus on other people's goals, wants, and needs, and I help them obtain it, the luckier, more blessed that I am. That's how I feel. And I continue that, and that fuels me. When I was younger, you know, I told you earlier, I'm almost 50, okay? 25 years ago, boy, I was a mother humper. Ask anybody on here that knows me when I was 25. You know, I was, money was my God and materialistic thing. I mean, I only cared about, I wasn't a bad guy. I mean, I was good to people. I wasn't mean, but my priorities weren't the same, okay? I probably was me first and everyone else, or me family, you know. And now, it's about other people, and then I get taken care of, and I feel that I'm lucky and I'm blessed the more that I can share with you. That's why I jumped on here today. I had these things in my heart. And some of you might say, boy, that guy's an idiot on there. And that's okay. You know, it doesn't hurt. It's no big deal. Sticks and stones, right? But hopefully if I touch somebody, maybe it changes things around. And the reason I wanted to jump on here, I almost procrastinated. That's a word that, whew, if, don't be a procrastinator, man. Just do it. Nike, just do it, right? But I jumped on here because I said, Dave, whatever you're feeling, there's a good chance that somebody on this globe that watches your live or watches the replay, okay, you might touch. You might wake something up. You might awaken that sleeping giant within them. You may be the difference in their year, you know. And I'm not looking for attaboys or kudos or because of you, you changed my life. But if it happens, that's what I'm after. At the end of this year, I hope somebody can look back and say, I'm glad I watched that guy's video. Man, because of that, I didn't waste 3 days of the year or 2 weeks of the year, the first 3 months of the year. And here we are sitting in April or June, and man, I got to get started. Let me tell you something. Your year is getting late if you start then. Let me tell you something else that my best buddy tells me, one of my mentors and greatest of all time, and just a rock star individual, him and his wife, they're my best friends. Two of my best friends. I have a few, but they're two of them. They always, you know, how you want this year to end, for, I don't know how you all celebrated last night, but if you want the end of 2019, when that ball drops and New Year comes for 2020, if you want December 31st to be fantastic that end of the year, you got to do it now, whatever the goal is. Money, family, relationship, weight, health, whatever, spiritual, doesn't matter. Whatever the goal, if you want it to be good then, you need to start now. The first quarter of this year, these first few months, starting right now, today, you got to get to work on it. Doesn't mean you drop everything. Doesn't mean that you you know, neglect your kids or neglect your wife or girlfriend or fiance. Doesn't mean that you neglect your job if you're going to get a second job or a side hustle or whatever. Or hell, doesn't mean you drastically change your life and flip it upside down. It just means get to work. You may have heard something like consistent, steady effort over time. Just go to work at whatever it is you want to accomplish, not a job work. What if it's work? Work. But whatever it is, do something consistently. Activity is what gets things going. And it creates good habits and it creates mental strength and healthiness and all this stuff. Get moving. Don't stay stagnant. Get yourself moving in the direction you want to go. So, you know, the one thing, I'm going to be closing here in a minute, but the one thing, because I don't want to talk all day, because you guys will definitely be chopping me off. But the one thing, excuse me, oh, see my glasses going in and out? Interesting. I never used this, so I thought it'd be a little change. Went with my jewelry today, my glasses. But you can still see my eyes. See, I'm a big believer, right? You got to smile, right? But the main thing is you got to see my eyes. So hopefully you guys can see my eyes still. I almost didn't wear them because I'm like, oh, I can't see your eyes. Because I was always raised, you got to open your eyes and look them in the eyes, you know, look them in the face. Because trusting. So hopefully you guys can see my eyes. I don't know if I can turn these glasses off or not, but I'm not going to try. I'll mess it up. But anyway, here's the one thing that you can't replace. Now, I'm going to go back a step because I talked about, you know, if you don't know me or it's the first time you ever seen a video or heard of who I am. I'm not nobody, but you heard of daveangelo is what I mean. And I talked about life circumstances. A lot of people are stuck in life circumstances, you know, and that's all around the world now. But let's just talk about America right now, this second, okay? America now, and for the last quite a few years, people are struggling big time, big time. Financially, for sure. A lot of emotional, a lot of families, broken homes, single parents, you know, all that stuff, divorces, all this stuff. And, you know, people are hurting. But unfortunately, we get so banged up, and there's so many people that are struggling financially, relationships broken, single homes, all this stuff, right? Sometimes, I don't say we do it, I was going to say consciously, but if you're alive, you're conscious, right? You know, we don't do it on purpose. It's not the intention, but because this stuff exists and it's familiar, it's all around, I believe that we take that as an excuse or kind of like a pat. It's okay. It's okay if I don't put in the little extra. It's okay if my health's not good. It's okay. You know, everybody has high blood pressure. I did. I got rid of my medication. 6 months ago, I was really not doing well. Today, laser focused, eye of the tiger. Okay. But we say it's okay. It's okay if I live week to week or I can't go on vacation or I don't got extra money in savings like I should or have insurance or whatever the case may be. We say it's okay because so many people are hurting. But to me, I'll be a little firm here. I hope I don't offend nobody. I've done it. It's an excuse. You're making an excuse to not elevate your life, to make your life better or your relationship or whatever. We won't rehash all that. If you missed it and you're just jumping on, go back and watch from the beginning. I don't want to repeat it for the people that have been here. However, we use things to be excuses. And I'll tell you something that I heard a couple days ago. A lot of times, now I'm a major let's see, what do we say? I am a major offender of what I'm about to share. I am hard on myself, really hard. And the reason is I've obtained some big things in my life, but I've been down in the gutter, believe me. But I always pull myself up, you know. For those of you who don't know, you know, I go by the Tiger. A lot of people know me as Tiger Man. They don't know me as daveangelo, but it comes from Rocky and the underdog and all that. I'm the high school dropout. I did have my diploma for a disclosure before my class graduated, but I am a high school dropout. But I was successful young, but I was hungry, you know. You know, so I pull myself out and so I'm really hard on myself. So the point I wanted to make is many times what we'll do is we'll look at where we're at. Like you might look at yourself right now. I recommend you do this. When you if you get off this live or you hear this live later today or tomorrow, stop a minute, just turn all the music off, the TVs, and just get by yourself and just think about where you are for a moment and what you want to do. And you can write them down or not, but a lot of people say you got to write them goals down. Not necessarily. Believe me, if you got goals, you know what they are, believe me. But anyway, you know, I'll beat myself up on stuff that I didn't do yesterday or last week, or what a lot of people will do today. You know, last night they're like, yeah, 2019 is going to be my best year. Guess what? They wake up today, if they were drinking, they sober up a little bit, and all of a sudden, bam, reality sets back in. 2019. See, just because the clock ticked over midnight, just because the calendar now says 2019, the things you had in your life today, yesterday, are here today. Okay, the stuff in 2018 are here today. They don't just go away because the ball dropped in New York City, and in America, we're like, hey, Happy New Year. Things don't change. Okay, for things to change, you need to change. For things to get better, you need to get better. So if you want things to change, make it happen now. Remember what I said in the very beginning? This can, you can keep saying one day I will, one day I'll start, or this can be day one of whatever you want it to become. So if you keep doing, you know that definition of insanity, that's got to be worn out by now. Keep doing the same things and expecting a different result. That is insanity. So if you want something, anything in your life to change, we talked about all the things it could be, right? If you want something to change, you need to change. Not the person next to you, not your coworker, not your spouse, not your kids, not your boss, whatever. Okay, here's one thing I'll tell you. I'm gonna close with this. The only person that can do something about your life is the person that you're looking at in the mirror every day, period. Now, I don't want to offend people, but I'm going to just talk real. Okay, doesn't matter who we elect for president. Doesn't matter who your mayor is. Doesn't matter your community. They all have an effect, of course, to a degree. But I can tell you, it doesn't matter, you know, drastically, all those things. The only one that can drastically change things, elevate your life in whatever level, is you, the person that you see in the mirror. And I've always known that, but I beat myself up. So let me tell you this. Don't worry about yesterday, because you can't change it. You can't change last year. You can't change nothing. If you carry it with you, it's just going to keep things going in the direction you don't want them to go. Unless everything's good, keep doing what you're doing. But if things aren't the way you want, you need to make changes. And why wait? Make changes today. Start today. Even if it's just a decision and you start to take action in a little bit. Because a little bit over time will get mountains of results. It doesn't need to be drastic. You don't need to go in right now and, if you're a man, go in and tell your wife, or wife tell your husband, and rattle your world. But make little changes, little adjustments every day, consistent. If you don't know about the doubling of a penny, go Google. I don't know how you find it, but you know, look at the compound effect of doing a little bit over time. And what I'm trying to say is, if you took a penny, 1 cent, little copper thing that they're trying to get rid of here in the U.S., okay, if you took one penny and you doubled that every day for just 1 month, so day one, a penny, day two, 2 pennies, you got 3 cents, you know, then the 4, then the 8, and you just double a penny every day for a month, look at what happened at the end of 30 days. Now, a lot of you know, but many of you might not know. You'd be wildly crazed out at what's going to happen on that 30th day, the 31st day. You can't even fathom if you don't know what I'm talking about. That's the same thing with your life. If you do a little bit, because a little bit consistently every day versus zero, it's going to move mountains for you and your family and your friends and your kids and your grandkids and all that stuff. You know, I talked about circumstances. I come back around again. I've been through some challenging stuff this past year. Okay. Actually, on December 28th, I told you I started my new year on the 26th. 28th, I got hit with 3 curveballs, major. Poof, poof, poof. I mean, left and right hooks, like they were, like I was in the ring with Mike Tyson. It was rough. And at, by midnight of the 28th, man, I won't say I was ready to check out, but I was hurting. I haven't posted about it. You know, I just said, man, I'm hurting right now. I'll be okay tomorrow. Because I know it doesn't last. See, when you're conditioned, everybody, we all get smacked across the face in life. If you go outside, that's what happens. You know, life happens. We get smacked around all the time. The difference is, how long do you let it affect you? Do you let it affect you 10 months, 10 weeks, 10 hours, 10 minutes? See, with me, it's 10 minutes. The other day, it was a couple hours. But, you know, it's quick. Boom, smacked, sting goes away, and you move on. That's how you got to treat things as they come at you. But life's going to happen. Challenges happen. You know, people unfortunately get sick. People pass away. People lose jobs. People get hurt. All kinds of stuff happens. But it's how you deal with what happens that matters. And the only one that can control that and has a choice is you, the person that we look in the mirror. So for me, I made a choice. I made a choice that regardless of all this stuff going on, something happened yesterday that crushed me. I'm going to get into it publicly, but yesterday, it was New Year's Eve. What a gift I got yesterday afternoon. It was horrible. Okay, but the bottom line is I had a choice to dwell on that or change things. So I can tell you this, unfortunately for myself, I've had a lot of loss in my life. Started with my mom when I was 15 years old, long time ago, 1985. You know, I lost my mom and later on my father and all the others. So I'm in my direct family, just about everybody's gone. Sandy and Karen are on here. They're my relatives. They're on here. But, you know, we don't have much family left, really at all. Cousins, niece, that's about it. Direct, you know, like a media fan, but my family. But I've had a lot of loss in life. I've had ups and downs. But the one thing, at age 50, I'm not old, I'm 49 and a half, but one thing we can't get back is this stuff, time, right? Yeah, right here on my arm. Okay, we can't get that back. We can get all kinds of things back. You can get money back. You can fix and mend relationships a lot of times. You can do a lot of things. But the one thing you can't replace is this, time. We can't, it runs out. And when it's gone, it's gone. And as we get older and you realize, it goes faster and faster. Believe me, you've heard this before. If we only knew now, or when we were young, what we know now, right? I would love to know what I know now 30 years ago. Boy, a lot less heartache. But unfortunately, that's not the way life is. Life has a funny sense of humor, right? So, you know, don't waste the time. 2019 is ticking. Here's one last other thing. Might not realize it when we're pointing fingers, you know, they got a great life. Why is it so easy and hard for me and all this stuff? Guess what? We all got the same time. We all got 24 hours in a day. We all got 365 days in 2019. Or maybe there's an extra one. No, I don't know if it's leap year. But bottom line is we got 365 days, give or take, right? It's what you do with them that counts. And again, don't measure your actions, your results, your outcome by everybody else. Just run your race at your speed, but stay consistent. Keep your eye on the ball, which is means your focus, your goal, whatever it is, and have at it. And here's another good nugget, if you want it, my opinion. Go hang around some good people to keep you on track. If you need a coach or mentor, get one. Okay, I'm free. Call me. But friends. Get new friends. And I mean that. And I mean it like you don't cut people out of your life. But don't hang around people that are negative or bring you down. Hang around people that encourage you, to inspire you, to push you to do what you want to do. Now, if there's friends that just want to sit around, and I don't mean this negative, because whatever you want to do, it's okay. If you want to sit around, I don't think Oprah's on anymore, but whatever's on in the afternoon, and you don't want to be held, you don't want to do any, that's fine. But if you're hanging with people that don't direct you, push you, and support you in the direction you want to go, whatever the direction is, then get around people that are. Now, I'm not saying disown them, but don't be around them so much. Because it is true. You've heard it, you know, you'll become the sum of your five closest friends. You know, that you will. So if you don't have people around you that are up, elevating you and lifting you up and encouraging you to do what you want to do, or when you say something that you're excited about and rather than say, oh, that's great, man, you can do it, or whatever it is. It don't have to be rah-rah, but you know what I mean. Or somebody that's always the I don't use any names, the blank downers, okay? If they're like, oh, yeah, but, you know, if they're not encouraging you, cut them out. Because at the end of the day, you answer to you or your family or your spouse or your kids or the man upstairs if you're a person of faith. Those people are not going to pay your bills. And unfortunately, because of what I said earlier in this live, people in this country or in this world, there's more people struggling than they're doing well. So unfortunately, when you're not doing well, there's more people to support you when you're not doing well. But when you actually try to step out and get ahead, when you try to do more and you want more for your family, for your spouse, for yourself, there's not that many people to support you because the masses are in the bad part of life. So remember, you're going to run out of time. So get started. 2019, very simple. You can make a choice and make a decision right now that I'm either going to A, be the person says, one day I will, or you're going to be the person like myself that said, today is day one. and do something, even if it's small. Make a decision, step one. Step two is take action. Remember, making a decision isn't good enough. Saying, I'm going to lose weight, I'm going to get healthier, I'm going to make more money, I'm going to be a better spouse, whatever. That's not enough. You can say it, that's a decision. But now you got to take some action. If you don't know how to take action to get the goal, find out from somebody. If you don't have somebody like that in your life, reach out to me, I'll help you. A lot of people, seen this before, some of you haven't. You've seen this tiger for many years. Maybe this tiger's been around, I don't know, 10 years, something like that. Yeah, it was. This tiger was born in July of 2019. It's coming up on 10 years. Tigers in general have been around for about 30 years since I've been an adult. But this particular tiger, Tiger Leadership's been around 10 years. Now, recently, you all seen this tiger turn pink, right? It's a shade of pink now because we're in the pink movement. We're helping women, elevating and edifying and encouraging and supporting. That's my mission now. I mean, I help men, don't get me wrong, for those of you that are men out there, but we're focusing on women, and there's a reason for that. And if you reach out to me, I'll talk to you about it. But the bottom line is this logo or that symbol, that's just bottom line is we help people. You know, that's our job. That's my job. My job is to help somebody, if I can, elevate and do what they want to do in life better than they are now at whatever it is. Again, it can be spiritual. It can be family. It can be money. It can be health. If I can answer, I can answer. Hey, everybody, I see y'all coming on. I appreciate it. I'm just getting ready to finish up. Hopefully, you guys got some nuggets. Hey, Denise. Hey, Yvonne. How you doing? Good to see you. Listen, so again, you know, hopefully you like these glasses today I was styling. Remember about the time. We talked a lot about time today. Just go out there and make it happen for yourself. If you haven't seen this, go watch the replay. Hopefully somebody on the globe gets a nugget that sees this. It'll be all over YouTube and stuff. You know, share this. By the way, if you listen to this, whether you've been on with me from the beginning, and thank you for those of you that put up with me this long, but whether you're watching this, you've been watching this from the beginning, or you're just getting on and maybe you go back and rewatch it, if you got something from this, one nugget, one thing I said might have inspired you or helped you or woke you up in some way. If you got anything positive, you know, give me some love or some likes, but more importantly, share it. Share this live out. Get it out there so somebody can hear this message. I hope it didn't come across. I didn't want it to be selfish in any way. There was no motive behind it. There's no intention. It's just I wanted to share information that was on my heart with all of you and some of the things that I do that maybe can help you all. So if you got something out of this, please hit the share button, share it out, comment, tag people, you know, go down in the comments, you know, tag people in it. If you think the message could specifically help a certain person, if not, just share it out and let's just get the message out and let's just help people, man. It's 2019. It's day one. Be the person that says it's the first day. Make a decision to change something in your life if you want. Don't be everything at once. Don't overwhelm yourself, because that's another thing. People got all kinds of things, money, issue, health. I've been there. I've been here. You know, pick one thing that's most priority, relationship, whatever it is, and focus on that one and just do a little bit. Do a little bit, you'll see things get better. Then pick another thing and do a couple more things and do a little bit and you'll see things get better. And just keep doing it. The main thing is stay consistent, because that consistent, steady effort over time, we've been using health as an analogy. I'll use one last thing. Let's say you're overweight, okay? I've been there too, still am a little bit. But, you know, say you're overweight and you're trying to lose weight. If you go start tomorrow and you eat totally healthy, you know, organic, no red meats, you know, perfectly healthy from a nutritionist, right? Low calories, low fat, all no chemicals. Do that all day long tomorrow, or even for 3 or 4 days. Are you going to instantly be extra healthy and lose all this weight overnight? Hell no. Okay? I don't usually swear on here, but that wasn't really swear. Hell no. I had to be. No. And it goes reverse. If you are totally healthy and you are Mr. or Mrs. Fitness and all that stuff that I'm not, okay? You know, even if you are that way, if you go out and eat, let's not use any names, fast food, all right? If you go out and eat some fries and burgers and chickens and cheesesteaks and pizza, you know, whatever, 10 times tomorrow or over the next week, that's all you eat is all that kind of fast food and all. are you going to be all of a sudden overnight blow up totally unhealthy or obese if you're already healthy? No. But if you make that little simple judgment error, you make the decision or choice to continue that, that error in judgment, that consistent, steady effort, good or bad over time, will affect your life. Same thing with the things that you want to improve. Don't say, because, you know, we're in a world of instant gratification, you know. I want to do something, I want a result tomorrow. That ain't going to happen, no matter what it is, okay? Things that come fast don't last, okay? Never mind. You know, things that are easy to get are not worth it. It's the things that don't come to you quickly, that aren't easy to get, that it takes a little work, they're the things that are worth it. Like I said in the very beginning of this, whatever you got to do, consistent and steady over time to get to where you want to get, when you get there, it's, I've arrived. I made it. To yourself, not to the world. Okay? I can tell you, when I have my successes, I don't care about anybody else. But to me, you know what you've done to get there, and that's all that matters. But when you get there, it doesn't matter how long it took. It doesn't matter how hard it was. It don't matter the challenges and obstacles and landmines you had to do it, because some things, depending upon what course you're on, some things are harder to do than others. Sometimes you got to dodge some landmines. Sometimes you get hit by a grenade, but you got to get back up, dust yourself off, and you need to keep going. There are no failures in anything you're doing unless you quit. Because if you haven't quit when you're on a journey and you're trying to do something, then it's just you're still on the journey. Doesn't matter how long it takes to get there. Forget about everybody else. You know, I'm not the fastest guy in the world to do something. Okay? But when you get there, then it all doesn't matter. Doesn't matter how long it took. Doesn't matter how hard it was. The gratification and the self, the pride that you'll feel for yourself, it's priceless. So, guys, I hope some of you got some good nuggets out of that. I kind of went all off. I didn't have notes or script. I just kind of, you know, I was slinging from the hip and shooting from the heart. Hey, Terrence, good to see you. Been a long time. Hope you're doing good there in the Carolinas. I want to wish everyone again a very, very, very happy new year and a very blessed year. And, you know, the only one that can make a difference is the person that you see in the mirror. So like I said, if you liked anything you heard here, you got any nuggets from it, or you think somebody can get something from something I said, or you just want to show off these styling glasses that I put on here electronically. I don't even know how they got here, but somehow with this machine they got here. But go ahead and please tag somebody in this, or go ahead and share it out, and let's try to get the message. And let's just help as many people as we can in 2019, because that's what this is about, by the way. Let me grab this here, you know, this isn't a commercial, so that's why I haven't talked to any business, but, you know, what I stand for in my company is really simply this. We make a difference in the world, one person at a time, one family at a time, for those that want to make a difference. And if you don't, that's okay too. You know, I don't judge nobody. Whatever you want to do is up to you, but my choice is to help people and find people that like to help people. Simple as that. And whatever they want to do, whether it's money or lifestyle or whatever it is. So, you know, we all can do that. If we just have a little bit of kindness and daily method operation, my daily method operation is be kind, help people, see what I can do for the world. You do that every day, little bit. And if we grow in numbers like that, imagine globally what's going to happen. And we got people in Australia, we got people in Hawaii, we got people in UK, we got people all over the world to do that. And the more we can spread that kind of message and that kind of talk, and we're a group and we're a community and we have unity like that, imagine what can happen in this world. Because the world's not always a pretty place. A lot of bad stuff go on out there. But we choose, again, who do we hang around? What do we follow? What do we do? What do we say? How do we treat people? It's all choices, all right? Everybody have a happy new year. I'm a message, text, or phone call away. If you want to talk to me or text me, message me. If you don't already have it, I'll send you my number. If you already have it, you know, just blow it up. You know, text me, call me, literally 24/7. I'll answer if I'm up. If I'm not, don't worry about it. I don't care if it's 3, 4 a.m., don't worry about it. You need somebody to talk to, you need to vent, whatever, give me a call, talk to me. I'm here for you. Everybody take care of yourself. It was great seeing a lot of friends here. I saw some that I haven't seen in many years. I saw a couple fly through that I don't think I saw in 30 years, so I'm glad they're here with us. Love you guys. I appreciate you all. Please share this video out, and I'll see you again soon. Everybody have a good day. God bless.